Luke here with Automate SQL. A few months ago, I created a video that shows how to do an unattended installation of Windows Server 2022. This video will kind of build up on that, where we'll use Sysprep with a answer file. So I use a lot of virtual machines in my sandbox, and I create those virtual machines using Packer and a golden image that I created with Packer. I found that if I didn't use Sysprep and I was trying to join some of those virtual machines to my domain, I was having basically duplicate SID issues. So I started implementing the use of Sysprep in my images. But one of the things I ran into when using Sysprep was then I was presented with a lot of questions. I had to enter the password. I had to enter locale information. A lot of things that was slowing me down in being able to automate the spinning up of those virtual machines using Vagrant. So I worked around that by modifying the answer file that we created in the previous video to also support using it with Sysprep. And I'm just going to show you those couple of components that I added into that answer file. And then I've updated the answer file on GitHub. And that I'll put the link to it below as well in the description. But let's go ahead and open up Windows System Image Manager. Again, if you're not familiar with Windows System Image Manager, I'll go through this tool in a lot more detail in the previous video. And again, I'll put a link to that somewhere on here. But anyway, let's jump in to the components that I've added. So this is that answer file. I've already got it open. And I went and added these two components to the generalize section. So the first one's Windows PNP Sysprep Neutral. And I've set these settings to do not clean up non-present devices to false, and then persist all device installs to false. So that has to do with if you were to use this image to create a VM on another machine that maybe the device drivers were not the same as the host that you used to create the image, then what this is going to do is allow Windows to go ahead and remove those devices and do some cleanup and then add the new devices, whatever's on that new host, to the VM. Here we're going to skip rearm. We set that to 1. So this has to do with there's a certain count of times that you can sysprep an image. I believe that's 3. You may want to Google that just to make sure. But this sets the skip rearm to 1. And if we jump down here to out-of-box experience system, I've added this one, Microsoft Windows International Core _neutral. This is going to be used to answer any of those locale prompts that you would get after sysprepping an image. So we're going to be able to skip right through that. I've set everything to English US. Again, this answer file has a few other components that we built out in the previous video, such as the password is in here for the admin account so that you're not prompted to create a password. Once you've got this saved, go ahead and I've already copied that file over to a machine that I'm going to use for this demo. That machine is called SRV3. It's just a Windows Server 2022 Standard Evaluation Edition that I'm using. And I'm going to copy that file over to the C Windows Panther directory. Let me go ahead and find it. Here it is. This is just on my host. I'm going to copy it to my guest. And then once that's in place, we're going to go ahead and open up PowerShell as an admin. And then I've already got a command here that we're going to use. This is part of my automated sandbox framework. And it's just where I use Packer to build my images, and then I'll use Vagrant to spin up all of my machines. But I'll just paste that here. Actually, let's try to grab that again. Once we've got that command pasted here, let's take a look at the switches we're using. We're using the generalize switch for sysprep, the out-of-box experience. Generalize is what's going to reset that SID for this computer. And then we're going to use the unattend switch, and we'll provide the autounattend XML file that we just created. And we're going to pass in the quiet so we're not prompted for anything from sysprep. And then at the end, we're going to shut down this machine. So let's go ahead and run this. Takes a minute or so, and then you'll see the machine shut down. All right, so it's shut down. We're just going to go ahead and power it back on. And if everything goes well, we should see a couple of reboots, but we shouldn't be prompted for any information because everything was provided using that answer file. Here you'll see a few PowerShell windows, and that's because we're doing some setup for WinRM and then firewall rules just to support Packer and Vagrant. So the machine is restarted, and you'll notice we didn't get prompted for any information. So at this point, you could join this to your domain or continue configuring it to however you need it to be configured for your sandbox. And I will show you real quick, just in case you haven't used sysprep before, I'll show you real quick what happens if we don't use an answer file. So if we go back into PowerShell, and just remember, you got to do this using PowerShell as an admin. And this time, we'll provide the generalized switch, out-of-box experience switch, and then quiet, and then shut down. We'll go ahead and restart it. And this time you'll notice we'll be prompted for the password and the locale information. So here it's asking for the country or region, preferred app language, US, and then the keyboard layout. Then you have to click next, accept the license agreement, and then you have to provide a password. And then we'll provide the password again. And at this point, if you were using WinRM, you'd have to set that up, and then also add your firewall rules and everything that the answer file did automatically for us. So as you can see, it's quite a time saver, especially if you're spinning up a lot of machines at once in your sandbox, or this is something you can even use outside of your sandbox. If part of your job is to create golden images to use for a lot of production virtual machines or even development virtual machines, this could help you in that scenario as well. So again, I'll put a link down in the description where you can grab this answer file so you can use it to learn more about it if you'd like. And then also a link to that previous video to where we go into more detail of using some of these tools. If you found this useful, like and subscribe down below, and I'll see you next time. Thanks.